No, play goes right on. The two referees let him go. Both teams are changing again on the fly with 9:20 left in the first. Canadiens get the puck over the line, and Yemelin takes a shot, hit a leg, and comes right back past him. The goalie leaving the net. Look out! Empty goal! Niederreiter! A bad move, as it turns out, by Mike Condon. And a great move by Niederreiter, 1-0 Minnesota.
Two times in this game, early in the first period, a puck has come near Mike Condon, and he's hesitated to go out for it. And I think a lot of it has to do with the fact he doesn't handle the puck particularly well. Here he comes out of the net, and as he comes out, the one place you do not want to throw this puck is up the gut of the ice.
There's holes in his game. You watch tonight where Hammond's been moving left, and the puck's gone right. You look at that tricky little bounce that you just saw.
There's a terrible bounce. Markov misplayed it.
It's just a dump. Catches a carom. Carey Price not sure what to do. Watch Markov's stick right there. He puts it right between Carey Price's legs. PK Subban takes advantage of that pass the net, and Markov just gets lost in front of the net and puts it right through Carey Price's leg. His stick gets caught in the pile. It was Zibanejad and Markov there to put it, sadly, past Carey Price for the first goal of the series for Ottawa.
Play goes way down. The Bruins player dumped it center. No call made. And Gallagher, after the puck in his own zone, couldn't reach it. Bruins keep it in, and they score. That was a tough one. Pasternak just shot it over at the net. How did that get in?
That is a wobbly one that I think goes along the goal line and glances in off Carey Price's skate and into the net. Pasternak gets in on the forecheck. He takes a pretty hard hit right there from Ben. He gets up off his feet. He gets over and gets this puck right here. Boston jumps on these pucks, and I think it might go off the heel of Price's stick. As it gets thrown out in front, he's got his stick out in front of him. And here's a look from the net cam, and it just looks like it might glance off the heel of the stick and then back through his legs. Oh, this will give us it right here. Oh, it goes off his back foot.
October the 25th when the Ducks were in Montreal. They score! Oshima caught Tokarski going out to play the puck behind the net.
Of the building here at Honda Center, there's the dump in. It's rimmed around by Kreswa Bolsterman, but it's off the stanchion right in the middle of the net. Boy, that is a tough one for Dustin Tokarski and the Ducks.
Kopetsky tire à son tour, le tir et le but! Ah, c'est bouillant, je pense, il a tiré. Il va s'excuser auprès de Bouda. Écoute, c'est un... quel jeu bizarre! La reprise va nous confirmer, là, mais...
Après avoir effectué tout un jeu contre Jack Skilly en défensive, Francis Bouillon va bloquer un tir depuis le point d'appui et en se retournant va diriger cette rondelle directement dans le filet défendu par Boudaille. Effectivement, Skilly n'aura jamais touché à la rondelle. On va probablement donner le but à Kopetsky. C'est bel et bien Francis Bouillon qui va régistir.
Played it up ahead to Max Pacioretty. Pacioretty threw it back to Stamkos. He's alone. Scores!
A miscue, and Steven Stamkos capitalizes for his 38th of the year and fourth goal in four games against the Habs.
A real tough break for the Montreal Canadiens, especially Max Pacioretty. And four-on-four hockey, you want to have puck control. You have the puck on your stick, you don't want to give it away. And right here, Pacioretty has no play, so he wants to go back to his D, but he didn't realize that Stamkos had fallen back behind the play. And instead, this puck's gonna go right to the stick of Steven Stamkos. Stamkos can't believe it. And it's not offside because it's Pacioretty throwing the puck back into his own zone.
A little extra attention might be a factor there. Oh, he's given away, and Peter Budaj has just assisted on the game tying goal by Vinny LeCavalier.
Back here, and that's more than a home welcome. Peter Budaj hasn't played a lot, misreads this one, puts it right on the tape of Vinny LeCavalier. Obviously wants to go back up the boards. Maybe can't see behind Chris Campoli to know that McAvey is right there, but puts it tape to tape. Defenseman couldn't have passed it any better.
Makes the play across to Thompson. Feeds it towards the net. They score! It was tipped in by P.K. Subban into his own net. And the Lightning score a shorthanded goal. They've got the 1-0 lead.
And it'll be credited to Nate Thompson. Excellent play. Just getting in there and trying to hit the player coming in off the wing. And there you see Subban intercepting that pass. And Brown was right there. And Thompson will get that shorthanded goal.
Nate without a goal for 17 games, and he'll take that one, and so will his teammates. And another shorthanded goal, the third one in five games for the Lightning.
D.K. Subban into the Penguin zone, lost control, Sutter takes it away. Brandon Sutter in on Boudin with a backhand, he scores! Brandon Sutter with a shorthanded goal, burns the Canadiens again.
Well, I got to tell you, Michael Therrien is steaming right now, and rightfully so. Subban was tired. I think a timeout might have been appropriate. Dumping the puck in would have been more appropriate by Subban, who was absolutely exhausted. And what a goal by Sutter. Picks the pocket. It was a delayed penalty. You see the referee's arm up. Goes to the backhand, elevates the puck. Sutter with another big goal against the Montreal Canadiens. We remember what Sutter did last year.
Potential scoring shot, Travis Moan. Boychuk up to the red line. A funny bounce for Caron. Room service with a nice tip for the winner.
You get that puck out of a dangerous area.
Off the faceoff. 1-0 Boston.
Well, faceoffs are such a key, and even though the Bruins lose this draw, Patrice Bergeron actually breaks his stick in this draw against Plekanec. It's just a misplay by Carey Price. Under the blade of the stick, inside the right skate, and into the net.
Montreal, he's got 30. Couture slaps it to the net. Boudin looking for it, and the puck's in the net, and it's a goal!
My friend.
Yeah, that's going to the net. Boudin just couldn't pick that up. It's in between his legs, but Wingles beats everybody to the puck. That's the second long shot the Sharks have taken on Boudin early in this game. This one shorthanded. Beats him to the puck, and just a nice play by Wingles. Good hustle.
Smart. Look at Logan Couture. His eyes up all the way, putting it right on the pads. It's the right play. A mistake by Boudin and a smart play by Tommy Wingles and Logan Couture.
Now 5-2. Perry trying to get around Mete. Right into the crease.
And another wonderful pass. What a pass by Corey Perry.
You're beat right to the crease. So you mentioned, well, we'll see how the Montreal Canadiens respond to some adversity. Not very well.
23 seconds. After the Montour.
That's not a good position to be in right there. You're Adam Lauer, you're about 30 feet off P.K. Subban, teeing one up on a one-timer. And you just got to stand there and take it.
Subban turns it over. Shifley, here he is. Scores! Subban wears the go towards Shifley. Gets the goal.
Classic case of trying to do too much. Throws the first spin around on Shifley. Now he tries to cut back, and Shifley stays with him. Shifley's fresh. Just off the bench, fresh legs, lots of energy. Subban's been out there for 2 minutes, and he gets himself in trouble trying to do too much. He's got to make the simpler play, get it up. Now it's not the time to try to dance a good offensive player like Mark Shifley, and he makes him pay. The quick strides here, pulling away. And a good finish while on his way down on the backhand. Gets the Jets the lead.